Og hvem fanden er du?
Jeg hedder Christian.
Christian. Hvad laver du med rottefjæset?
Rottefjæset?
Jeg er dum, eller hvad? Prøv at se tænder. Kan du ikke se en lignende rotte?
Nej, men jeg går heller ikke rundt og glor, end jeg andre folks mund, vel?
Du skal gribe, Christian.
Og du trækker bare en cykel hjem, ikke? Rottefjæs.
Er du okay?
Ja.
Nu er der altså virkelig undskyld.
What does that add to a story when you sort of see it through the perspective of children? Is there a view more black and white of the world, or?
You know, I think it's probably one of the differences between children and grown-ups is that children have a more black and white view of the world. And one of the whole things of the concept of the story is that these children actually, during the course of a film, grow up and by the end of a film has a more complex, but also more compassionate view of the world.
Was there any point during the filming where they kind of struggled with some of the more emotional scenes, or?
Yeah, I mean, the guy, the boy who plays Christian basically plays a, it's like a kind of a grown-up part, it's like an adult part played by a kid. And he's a very nice, very well-educated boy, and I think he had a hard time being horrible. In the beginning, he kind of felt very uneasy having to scream and even having to hit his father, but I think when he realized that this is fun, this is, you know, that at some point the director's gonna say cut, and you can then be this well-behaved, nice kid again, he threw himself at it, and he thoroughly enjoyed it.
Hvorfor lyver du hele tiden?
Prøv at høre. Det er jo fuldstændig vanvittigt, det her. Og du skal lade være med det der lyveri hele tiden, for jeg lyver ikke. Jeg gør ikke. Jeg har ikke løjet over for dig på noget tidspunkt. Jeg har ikke. Kig på mig. Jeg har ikke løjet over for dig. Jeg har
du sagde
ikke.
Til mig, hvor hun nok skulle blive rask! Du sagde også, hun ikke er ondt!
Tror du ikke, at jeg er lige så ked af de her ting, som du er, bror?
Nej, det tror jeg faktisk ikke, du er. Du er nemlig her, hun skulle dø. Det ved jeg, du ville. Hvorfor indrømmer du det ikke bare? Du ville have, hun skulle dø!
Well, was the story based in any part on true events? You came up with the story, is that correct?
Well, the writer, Mr. Jensen, and myself did the story, and it's not really based on true events, although some of the things in Africa is based on true events, mm-hmm. because we dealt a lot with Doctors Without Borders, and like the story of Big Man is actually based on a real character.
Hoping wasn't based on
yeah, that's exactly what you want. But the thing is, I don't think we would have dared writing anything as horrible has that not been based on a real character.
Right. And can you expand a little bit on the sort of theme of sticking up for yourself and taking matters into your own hands when maybe, you know, the school can't control something, or with the case of the Big Man, like the village couldn't.
Well, I mean, you know, you can't tolerate anything. The whole thing is that, yes, forgiveness is better than revenge, but you can't tolerate anything, and you can't tolerate somebody being bullied, and you can't tolerate a guy who cuts up pregnant women. So at some point, you have to confront yourself with those kind of elements of evil. That does not mean that the movie sort of think that you should just go out and avenge anything, or revenge, because actually the movie clearly states that you are never going to get the satisfaction you are aiming at.
Jeg savner dig.
Det må være svært for Elias, at hans far er væk så meget.
Rejser så meget.
Hej, far.
Har vi sagt, at vi skulle lidt ringe i dag, eller hvad?
Jeg fik bare lyst til at tale med dig.
Det her, det er Christian. Christian har lige flyttet til fra London.
Mor, din mor, han. Hun er død. Hun har kræft. Min mor og far er også i gang med at blive skilt.
Og hvem fanden er du?
Hun hedder Christian.
Jeg mener, du skal gribe Christian.
Er du okay?
I've seen that type of injury before. It's the work of a local villain, Big Man.
If
fix my life.
What all is you? Zol Kabul, Lila Zol Maquis.
Du slår ham, du slår han dig. Du slår ham, du slår dig. Du holder dig aldrig op.
Man går inte runt och slår folk. Det är inget som blir bättre. Jag tror att du får för värld om du har det.
Jag
tror att jag kommer nu. You can't go!